This cruise control system affects the operation of the vehicle's throttle and therefore acceleration. It is recommended to have an experienced professional install and calibrate this system. This video is not designed to replace the supplied installation and operation manuals. Late model daily drivers are raising the bar on our hot rods and classics. Luxuries like air conditioning, cruise control, and overdrive are quickly becoming non-negotiable when planning a project. We've seen a sharp increase in demand lately for cruise controls, with customers citing comfort as the number one reason, followed by increased fuel economy and maybe a few less speeding tickets. Whatever your reason for adding electronic cruise control, you're going to love the modern convenience. The CRS 2000 and 3000 packages come complete with the control module with 44-inch cable. Also in the box, you'll find the wiring harness, a pack of installation hardware, universal mounting bracket, a good set of instructions, and the control switch specified purchase. Once you're familiar with the components and have looked over the instruction manual, begin installation. The cruise control system includes hardware to connect to nearly any mechanical throttle linkage. Whether it's cable or lever, you're bound to find something in the bag that'll work. Getting the throttle cable dialed in can be easier on your bench, so we'll start our installation here. In the hardware pack, you'll find a 1032 lock washer nut. This can be used to thread the plastic cable housing. Once the threads are formed, the cable stay or steel flag nut can be threaded on. Starting the lock washer nut can be tricky, but once it grabs, an 11mm box end wrench is all you need. As the nut is spun, it digs into the housing, creating threads. Two inches of threads is ideal. Back the nut off before putting your preferred end on. For our installation, we need a square cable stay to snap into our bracket. By threading the cable end forward or back, you can adjust cable tension or slack. The flag nut threads on the same way. There are several variables to keep in mind when mounting your cruise control module. When possible, avoid moisture and heat while maintaining accessibility, and plan out your cable and wire routing. It's good practice to disconnect the positive battery cable before beginning installation. We decided to mount the cruise module on the firewall. We used the supplied mounting bracket bent at a 90-degree angle and used the self-tapping screws to secure to the firewall. This location will keep the unit dry and away from engine heat, plus it points the cable toward the throttle body. The programming switches and status LED are positioned down, but the mounting screws will be easy to access on the top. Pulling out these two screws allows for quick removal should we need to make an adjustment. The supplied coarse thread screws can be run into the module with a 10mm socket. The module is secured, so now we can run the cable toward the throttle body. Your goal here is gentle bends, steering clear of the exhaust and front accessory drive. Secure the cable as necessary to ensure it does not move while in use. This Chevy 1500 already had a dual cable bracket we could use for the CRS cable. The supplied snap-in adapter fits easily into the stock bracket. The throttle lever on this engine had an unused stud we were able to snap the supplied connector over. We adjusted the cable until there was no slack. Any drooping here should be avoided, but don't make it so tight that the throttle blades are open at rest. A strategic cable tie keeps the cable from moving around during operation. With the control module mounted, start looking at the wiring. It's good practice to begin with the farthest away components and work inward. Generally, this is the vehicle speed sensor, so start there and run the wires to the module. Then, look for your next component. Bundle the wires together whenever possible to keep them safe from hazards as well as electrical noise, such as spark plug wires or high output ignition modules. The CRS cruise packages can be used in nearly any application, whether you have a mechanical speedometer cable or a late model transmission that only offers an electronic VSS output. For applications with a mechanical speedometer cable, our supplied pass-through pulse generator should be installed between the transmission and cable. The coupler nuts thread onto a GM transmission, while the sensor features male threads suitable for the existing cable. For Ford applications, Dakota Digital offers an adapter for the sensor, though a custom cable with a GM-style 7/8 inch female thread collar will be required to complete the installation. If adding a pulse generator to the mechanical speedometer cable is not an option, the SEN4165 magnetic pickup kit can be utilized. This package consists of four small magnets to be installed on the drive shaft, along with a magnetic pickup coil to read vehicle speed. If you're running a Dakota Digital instrument system with a dedicated speed sensor or ECM output connected to the speed send terminal, you're in luck. The control box speed out terminal will provide a 4,000 pulse per mile speed signal, which can be used for the cruise control speed input. Unfortunately, this output is not active when used with BIM-01-2 OBD2 interface. If you're running a fully electronic transmission like this 4L60E, you won't have provisions to attach a pulse generator. Luckily, these transmissions already provide an electronic speed signal, which puts you a step ahead, though you can't simply splice into these VSS wires for the cruise. Utilize the VSS out wire on your ECM harness or a Dakota Digital STA-1000 interface, which captures speed data without interrupting vehicle operation. For applications outside these options, contact our sales department for other possible solutions. The cruise packages include your choice of control switch, whether a turn signal stock or a dash-mounted switch. Either option is a simple plug into the cruise control harness, though physical installation does vary. To avoid dealing with the airbag steering wheel in this pickup, we're going to mount the HND2 switch in this flat spot on the dash. We use the template to drill the three holes required for installation. Of course, before any tools are fired up, we'll remove the bezel to check for clearance and avoid drilling through any vital parts behind the bezel. The center hole allows the wires to pass through out of sight. We've got the switch mounted and have run the wires down toward the main cruise harness. Next, we'll plug the switch wires into the white connector, matching the wire colors to the letters on the connector, and plug the HND harness into the main. While under the dash, locate and make your connections for ignition, power, and ground, along with the hot side of the brake switch. Ensure any new wiring done under the dash is safely away from moving components like the steering column, pedals, and the driver's feet. The cruise system requires a simple wiring harness to be integrated to the vehicle. The wire color functions are as follows. Ignition power is brown. Locate a clean source of ignition controller power. Connect the black wire to a solid chassis ground. The tack wire is dark blue and connects to the negative side of the coil or tack output. This is used for runaway protection. Cruise control engaged signal is an orange wire. This could connect to a Dakota Digital gauge system or a separate indicator to let you know that the cruise control is turned on. The purple wire connects to the cold side of the brake switch. This requires nearly direct ground connection. If your project vehicle is equipped with LED taillights, a relay needs to be added to the violet wire in the cruise harness. LEDs do not provide a ground to the violet wire as a traditional bulb would. Adding a relay to the circuit ensures a clean on-off signal on the violet wire, and therefore positive cancellation of the cruise when the brake is applied. Dakota Digital sells a 30-amp automotive relay for this purpose. The speed input, or VSS, is gray. This connects to either a Dakota Digital control box speed output terminal, an ECM connection, or an inline pulse generator. The VSS input for the cruise is programmable between 2,000 and 40,000 pulses per mile. When it comes to setting up the cruise control, there are 12 programming switches used for calibration and fine-tuning. These are dip switches, simply on or off, and you can use a pen or another fine-point object to move them. Switches 1 and 2 adjust the gain or sensitivity of the cruise control. Modifying the combination of switches on or off changes how quickly the cruise will make an adjustment to stay on your set speed. With both switches off, sensitivity is at the extra low setting. Start here, especially with high-powered or lightweight vehicles. Turning switch 1 on changes the sensitivity to low. Reversing the pair puts the system sensitivity at mid. And finally, both switches on yields the highest sensitivity setting. The cruise will be very quick to adjust speed and may end up surging in lightweight or high horsepower applications, or in areas with hilly terrain. The cruise control system monitors vehicle speed, be it from a mechanical pulse generator, inductive pickup, or other electronic source. Speed is measured by the number of pulses per mile. The unit can be adjusted to accommodate the signal you're feeding it. Adjustable from 2,000 to 38,600 pulses per mile, most vehicle-driven speed sensors are acceptable, but for higher pulse count applications, Dakota Digital part number SGI-5E may be required to cut the signal down to an acceptable rate. Refer to your supplied installation manual for all 16 setting combinations. For example, the Dakota Digital sensor, such as the SEN014160, provides an 8,000 pulse per mile signal, so switches 3 and 4 should be on, while 5 and 6 are off. Magnetic pickup coil SEN4165, when installed with all four magnets, also offers 8,000 pulses per mile. The signal from a Dakota Digital Instrument System control box can be changed from 2,000 to 4,000 pulses per mile. Switches 7 through 9 adjust the setup timer, which is how quickly the cruise control starts maintaining speed when the set button is pressed. Adjust these switches according to the number of cylinders your engine has and at the lowest setting. Start with switches 7 through 9 off for V8 applications. At initial engagement, if the cruise drops off 5 miles per hour, engages, then slowly comes up to the set speed, change to high. This increases the reaction of initial pull and lock for the cruise. Most two-wire sensors supply a sine wave, while three-wire sensors, the VSS output from a Dakota Digital control box, and most ECM outputs are square wave. Switch number 10 tells the cruise module what type of signal it is receiving. Off for a sine wave, on for square. Turn switch 11 on if you're running an automatic transmission, or off for a stick shift. There are two types of control switches for this cruise module. HND 1 and 3 are normally closed switches, while HND 2 is normally open. With everything set up, but before you take a test drive, try to contain your excitement and run through the diagnostic process to ensure all of the connections and settings are correct before getting out on the road. To put the cruise into self-diagnostic mode and ensure it's receiving basic signals for operation, including power, ground, vehicle speed, and input from the control switch, turn your control switch off and the vehicle ignition off. Applications using HND 1 and 3 turn signal levers, slide the resume Excel slider all the way over and turn the vehicle ignition on. Then you'll see the red status LED in the control box is lit. Applications using HND 2, hold the resume Excel switch up while turning the system on. The diagnostic LED should be off at this time. You are now in self-diagnostic mode. Press and release the set coast button. Each time the button is pressed, the status LED should illuminate. If it's not, check programming switch 12. This switch should be on for normally closed switches and off for normally open, such as the HND2. If set incorrectly, reset and then re-enter diagnostic mode. Next, we'll test the resume Excel function. Each time the switch is moved, you'll see the red LED indicator illuminate. If not, check power to the cruise module as well as the cruise control switch. You'll need a second person to help perform this next test. Press and release the brake pedal. The status LED should light each time the pedal is pressed and go out when it is released. If not, check power to the red brake positive wire and check the brake switch connector and wiring to the brake switch. Step number 8 is a test of the VSS source. You can roll the vehicle forward and back at least 2 meters or around 6 feet. Alternatively, jack up the drive wheels and rotate the wheels by hand. As you do, the status LED should flash and continue flashing at the same rate. If it's not flashing, check the vehicle speed sensor or the source of the VSS. Keep in mind the cruise control can still pass this test even if the pulse count is too high or too low. If your new cruise system passed the diagnostic test process with flying colors, you should be ready to take a test drive. The cruise must be road tested. Putting the vehicle on jack stands will not cut it. Once out on the road, try out all of the functions of the cruise, including set, resume, and Excel, keeping in mind that the system will not engage below 45 miles per hour. Also, cancel the cruise control using the switch and brake pedal to ensure both work properly. You may wish to make some adjustments to the operation. If so, revisit the programming switches to help dial it in for your vehicle. You should be all set, ready to hit the road on your next hot rod adventure, only this time, you won't have a sore leg when you arrive.